gentlemen and ladies, ladies and gents, we have a song for you, and it's by Whitney Houston, the late, great, great, great Whitney, and she's, again, been through her struggles.
I've been so many places in my life and time.
At first, when I heard this song, I didn't like it because it wasn't Regina Bell. It wasn't Ray Charles. But you know what? I listened to it later and I said, you know, this woman did all right on this song. That was Whitney, y'all. She threw her own spin. She wasn't trying to sound like Ray Charles. She wasn't trying to sound like Regina Bell. She was trying to sound like Whitney. Who could fault her for that? Because everybody and their grandmother, no matter what they say about Whitney, they admit that that woman can sing. Okay? Not past tense. Not past tense. Can sing. Not did sing or could sing, but can sing. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a couple of things we need to talk about. We're going to talk about land grants. While we talk about land grants, I want you all to hold on to something. Okay, there are two videos that were up. They were recent videos, but however, I'm one of Jehovah's Witnesses, and I have to remember that at all times. I'm not a part-time witness. There are some part-time witnesses out there now. I ain't one of them. I don't allow cursing on my channel, and although it wasn't my intent to put that up there, one video the guy cursed, and I missed bleeping him out. And then the last one, the police choking thing, the police choke officer and the other officer curses, and I left it up there. My conscience has been kicking my butt. I told y'all, I gotta live with my conscience. And I also gotta live with my relationship with my God. My God does not tolerate cursing. I know all of you do what you do. And you gotta deal with that in your own time, because he ain't never gave you permission. He ain't never gave you permission. I don't give a what you say. He ain't never gave you permission. He didn't say it's okay in certain situations. It's okay when you get upset. It's okay when you're not feeling well. It's okay when you're at school. It's okay when you're at work. It's okay when you're joking with one another. He ain't say nothing like that. But what about you? You always sitting up there getting close. That's right. So you cannot say that that is it, because you, if you perceive that that's what it is, that's your imagination, not mine. Okay? Your imagination, not mine. I have my own imagination. And let me tell you, oh God, it's a vivid one. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as we drift through the clouds, let's talk about land patents. Now, first, you guys must understand what's going on with the land. We showed you guys the United States bankruptcy document. Okay, where it says all property in the United States is owned by the United States, and any so-called ownership is mere usury at the will and the dictate and the behest of the state. Now, if you've never thought that, we showed you on a video yesterday where in California, property taxes are listed as use taxes, because you're being charged for using government property. You already know that your automobile, you have a certificate of title. You don't have the actual title. A title is called a title, okay? You have a certificate of title. Okay, so you really do need to understand that. And some of y'all ain't gonna get that for a long time, and I'm sorry, I can't help you. Okay, you just gonna be that way for the rest of your life, baby, and I can't help you. Okay, so you like Dionne Warwick, y'all gonna have to live with that. Okay, go ahead and tell them, Dionne. All right, ladies and gentlemen, what is a land patent? Well, remember, the very first act respecting the earth was what? The earth was void and was without shape because the water was covering the vast watery deep. The whole surface of the earth was covered with water. There was no land. And what did he do? Did he not cause a separation between the water and the land? So, ladies and gentlemen, land has always been scarce on the earth. Although it looks like there's a lot of land on the earth, there actually isn't. 75% of the land is covered with water. Water. And or ice. So there isn't that much land. Only 25% of the earth's surface is being used. That's even when you talk about the flat earthers. Sorry, we ain't gonna get into that conversation. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's get this point real clear. The most valuable thing that you can own on the planet right now, according to man, not according to biblical standards, but according to man, is land. Well, guess what? You are land. All of the minerals in our earth is in you. Every single one of them, including uranium. What, you didn't know you had uranium inside your bodies? You must understand, you guys are nuclear fusion vessels. If you don't understand, I can't help you. Because man to this day cannot explain how we operate, where we get our energy from.
Oh, isn't that what EEON means? Energy equals oneness?
Okay, ladies and gentlemen. No, I'm sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, let's help you all to understand this. Because government says they owned your land. Because government says that you are just using the land, you haven't corrected the record. You need to correct the record, ladies and gentlemen. So we did a video yesterday talking about your taxes and property taxes and automobile taxes and what forms you should be filling out. Each state has its own separate form. You'll have to call your state to find out what form they have, okay? Been telling you this for years, that you should not be paying property tax on your primary residence. The form that they produce recognizes and acknowledges that. But you have not taken control of the securities held in your minor account, which is your property. You see, even though all property in the United States is owned by the United States, they don't have a right to that property. They are subjecting that property from people. Why? Because you haven't stood up. Now, you don't go demanding. Don't you dare go in there demanding nothing. You go in there with your paperwork, and you follow their procedures and their policies because they got a policy and procedure for it. Okay? And if they don't do what they're supposed to do, then you appeal that. Then you appeal it to the highest office. And after you've done your administrative process, follow me. You don't go following a lawsuit, people. No, you go get you a summary judgment. Okay, because they can't break their own laws. It's an administrative process. You shouldn't be going to court. You should be getting your summary judgment. Summary judgment is not a trial court, people. That's just a judge making a ruling on your paperwork. So that's why you document everything. Okay, I hope some of you understood that. If you didn't, go back and listen to it. Because again, you're not following their procedures. You're not following their policies. You're not following their process. I don't give up if you're sitting up here saying that you have. Okay, because you haven't. Because if you have, then that means you would have done everything I just stated. And you would have what you were looking for. You would have your remedy. You don't have your remedy because you're not following the process. Okay? Just that simple. Just that simple. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about land patents. I've opened this right here by itself, and we're going to do that, land patent. W-H-A-T is a L-A-N-D-P-A-T-E-N-T. Question mark. What is a land patent? Because there's a patent for everything. You have property patents, and you have intellectual patents, and you have all kind of patents. You know, you have general patent. And patent. And so you have a lot of patents, people. So we got to find out what is a land patent. ladies and gentlemen, I don't know this song. I do know it's from the 70s. It says Love Lock by Matoom. I don't know the song. I played it at least once before, but I don't know the song. Ladies and gentlemen, like I said, I don't know why this ain't getting to the site. It's irritating, so I gotta do something. Let me put y'all on pause for a second while I get to the site. Don't want to be wasting y'all time. Y'all done wasted enough of mine. Oops, didn't mean to say that out loud. My bad. My bad. I apologize. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to go here. The WWRPlaw.com. Yeah, they're going to talk about myths. Because a real myth. It's not a myth. I want you guys, they're going to give you the history. You may have seen signs staked in someone's front yard and thumbtack on the front door reading, "Warning, this property is protected by a U.S. land patent. Beware. If you are a revenuer, you have had problems collecting taxes from the owner of this house. The person inside the probably thinks little like Fox Mulder. But for most of us, the rest of us," he says, "reference to a land patent sounds too ecstatic, too outdated, or simply too confusing to worry about. In fact, land patents are still enforceable in Michigan." Throughout the entire United States, sorry, because it's a federal issue, not a state issue. "But typically, not for the reasons normally hoped for by those who would post these signs." By the way, ladies and gentlemen, he's talking about people posting signs. The land patent has nothing to do with a sign. Okay, he's talking about sign language. We ain't talking about no sign language. Okay, we're talking about a land patent. We're talking about actual evidence of ownership. Hold on. They're going to talk about history. "As the population of the United States grew, the federal government was interested in moving people off the East Coast into the woods out west. To that end, land office was created. The land office was created to sell land. At various intervals throughout the 1800s, the land office sold land to those daring souls, not by deed or other conveyance for a fee, but by patents. These land patents served as the early forms of title through which people could assert their ownership as against all others." These, hold on, we gotta highlight this because I want y'all to understand this was the law, okay? This was the cutie pie. Y'all know surface? I mean, one way. Well, I don't know what I said surface for. One way, ladies and gentlemen, cutie pie. Hold on now, let's do this right here. Hey, one way, y'all hold on. We're gonna go back the other way in just a second, okay? We're gonna do a U-turn and come right back to you. So we're gonna go the other way. So you hold on now. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna highlight this because it is necessary that we blow this up. Oh, you gonna blow it up, bruh? You a terrorist or something? Oh yes, you better believe I'm a terrorist. I'm a terrorist against the ignorance of the system that wants people to believe that they don't like this idiot who wrote this. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the law back then. These land patents served as the early form of title through which people could then assert their ownership against all others. It was a law deal. Hold on, just need y'all to make sure. These land patents served as the early forms of title through which people could then assert their ownership. Now, don't take my word for it. Do the research. I guarantee you the so-called land office is now known as the Bureau of Land Management. Go ahead and do your research and prove me. Tell me I'm wrong. Because I ain't looked it up. I ain't going to look it up now either. I want you to do that research. Tell me I'm wrong. Tell me I'm wrong that the Bureau of Land Management is not affiliated in any way with the original land office or land patent office, because that's what they issued, land patents. Did they change the law? Did this so-called land patent right end somehow? Did they eradicate it? Was there a constitutional amendment that said you could no longer do this? Because owning property is a right. It's not a privilege. So if they're going to take away this right to get title to your land, because it's not a statutory provision, right to own property is not statutory. It is constitutional. Better go back and look at the Fifth Amendment. Fifth Amendment highlights it right there. Got the right to your property. And by the way, the Fourth Amendment says you got the right to be secure in your property. So y'all go ahead and understand what's going on here. Now let's do this. Let's read on. I ain't been to the site before, people. We're going to it for the first time. I ain't never had to look this up for y'all. The territory of Michigan, upon admission to the Union as a state, acquired sovereign jurisdiction and police powers over all lands within its boundaries, not then in federal custody. With this grant of power, who did they get it from? The Michigan legislature gradually developed state regulation over these properties within its boundaries. Ladies and gentlemen, before they became states, the United States government claimed ownership of the land. Remember, in order for them to become a state, it had to have been a possession or territory of the United States. They just couldn't make themselves a state just because they felt like it. That's like the people in Cuba saying, we want to be part of the United States. By the way, if you go and do your research, Cuba is under the protection of the United States. It is a territory of the United States. Shh, don't tell nobody because you would disrupt a whole lot of stuff. All right, let's continue, shall we? Understand that when Michigan became a state, it did not gain control over the land in its territory. Why? Because the land in its territory is owned by the federal government. If you don't believe me, go back and look at the March 9, 1933 Act Congressional Record. They document it plainly. Don't take my word for it. Take theirs. The effect of land patents. So remember, he said, no, this is a myth. He said, this doesn't exist. But now he's going to say what the effect of land patents were. Pay attention. They were from the federal government, which means the state has no jurisdiction over the federal government. So what did this do to the land patents of the federal government? Today, some people believe that being able to trace their title of their property to the United States land patent somehow exempts their land from various forms of government regulations. Unfortunately, for these libertarian idealists, this is a myth. That's not true. Because guess what? A land patent under the United States government is the same thing as an Indian reservation. The state has no jurisdiction over regulating Indian reservations. It is its own territory. Well, the state has no jurisdiction in regulating government property. You don't believe me? Go ahead and look at all government buildings and see how the state has no authority over it. There are even statutes which says the state has no authority over federal property. Well, if all land is owned by the United States government, it's federal property. If the Bureau of Land Management issues you a certified copy of your land patent with their seal on it, that is the government relinquishing that to you. All you have to do is an acknowledgement and acceptance of that and file it into the county record. That's how you place the United States seal over the state seal. Now, don't take my word for it. Do your research. This idiot is saying this is all a myth. I've actually done it. You see how upset and pissed off they are because I did it. Because it's a grandfather position. Okay? These are grandfather laws. They are backdated past these states becoming states of the Union, including California. Most of the land in California is the Hidalgo Treaty. Arizona, Utah, New Mexico. Hidalgo Treaty. You know the Mexican government still owns most of the land in California? I have a guy who actually found that out. Moved on land that he knew the Mexican government owned that the United States wasn't doing nothing with. It was just sitting there. Mexican government owned. You know what he did? He sent the Mexican government rent. He figured out what the rent would be, and he sent it to him. This guy is no so-called sovereign citizen or anything like that. This was just somebody who did his own research. didn't watch nobody's videos, did his own research, found this out, sent it to the Mexican government, and now he has an agreement with the Mexican government that he can stay on that land, he pays them rent, and he has no regulations. So don't tell me that this idiot, what he's saying, is not true. Okay, because he is exempt. He doesn't pay any taxes to the American government at all, not the state of California at all. He is on solar. He's off grid. I know the gentleman. Okay, he was introduced to me by a family member. I was going to help him with a problem he had, but we got discombobulated with everything else going on in life. Okay, in Michigan, land patents are still statutorily protected and are still used to establish ownership interest in real property. Hear that, Michiganians? You better understand it. However, land patents do not affect the manner in which someone may use their property. That is a lie. Because a land patent, hold on, let me let him tell you what a land patent does. A land patent serves as an early form of title through which people could then assert their ownership against all others, and that includes the state. My bad. I apologize, because he said that. The United States Supreme Court, doesn't matter what the Supreme Court said, the Supreme Court does not set law in the United States. They never did. Now, I'm going to read what they said, but I'm already telling you that I know for a fact that the United States Supreme Court does not set the law in the United States. And the United States Supreme Court the United States Supreme Court, anytime United States is before the entity that makes that corporation an administrative agency. But remember, SCOTUS is the Supreme Court of the United States. That's SCOTUS. The Supreme Court of the United States is SCOTUS. This is USSC. USSC. This ain't the same court. And if you ever thought it was, go back and look at the two different names, United States Supreme Court and the Supreme Court of the United States. Two different courts, two different capacities, two different hats, chef. I mean, captain, I mean, sergeant, I mean, the sheriff, I mean, mayor, you know what I'm saying? They have a lot of capacities. It's all about capacity and not about reality. Because milk is gone. I'm sorry, my bad, I apologize. Whew. We're gonna get back to one way in a minute, okay? Because I need my music. Anyway, Supreme Court has plainly stated that land transferred by the federal land patent is subject to the same limitations as any other land under state jurisdiction. Actually, no, it is not. And I'll explain to you by reading what the Supreme Court says here. Now, he emphasizes this. We hold the true principle to be this. We hold the true principle to be this. How do you hold the true principle? Either it's the true principle or not. We hold the true principle to be this. So wait a minute. You're now stating what the true principle is? You're stating a principle, you're not stating a law? I'm sorry, that's somebody saying, hey, good job, you guys secured that land. Okay, we hold the true principle to be this? The true principle? We don't want a principle, we want a law. The Supreme Court is supposed to come to facts and conclusions of law, not facts and conclusions of principle. By the way, when they're relying on principle, pay attention, when they're relying on principle, they're acting administratively. When they're relying on facts and conclusions of law, they're acting as SCOTUS. The United States Supreme Court. Okay, let's go ahead. That whenever a question in any court, state or federal, is whether a title to land which had once been a property of the United States government has passed, that question must be resolved by the laws of the United States. That question must be resolved by the laws of the United States. Hold on. I want you to make sure of one thing. What are the laws of the United States? It's not statutes, because statutes are not law. Because anytime a judge is enforcing a statute, he is said to possess no judicial power. So statutes are not law, they're administrative. That's all they are, they're administrative. So let's keep going. But whenever, according to those laws, the title should have passed, then that property, like all other property in the state, is subject to state legislation, so far as the legislation is consistent with the admission that the title passed and vested according to the laws of the United States. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to pay attention to what was said. It says, but whenever according to those laws, not statutes, but the laws of the state, which is the Constitution of the state, that is the official law. Remember, in the United States, the Constitution is the supreme law of the land. Well, statutes are not part of the supreme law. So they are not the law. The supreme law of the land is your right to property. That's why there can be no excise on your right to life or your right to property. You cannot be taxed on your right to property. Government has no excise or control over your right to property. Pay attention. I'm giving you the law. I'm not telling you the law. I'm giving you the law. Your right to property and your right to have that property without excise, without penalty, is principle founded and sealed in law. These very same idiots who call themselves Supreme Court justice have recognized that. Hold on, wait. I want y'all to pay attention. That title shall have passed. Then that property, like all other property in the state, like all other property in the state, that includes the people, is subject to state legislation. Actually, no, it is not subject to state legislation. Congress has limited authority, and its authority does not give it legislative power over all property, including your own personal property. Go back and look at the Constitution. Their authority is limited. Congress's power, even the state Congress's power, is limited. The original Congress's power is only delegated to that of D.C. and no other area. You don't believe me? Go back and look. They have a delegatory authority. Now, they have since, on principle, said that, no, it extends throughout the entire United States. No, because Congress has no authority over the state. Congress only has authority over federal property, federal lands. But because the United States government owns all property, the United States government exercises authority over both land and sea. The Potomac River, river that's gone forever, and all land, including the people. Go back and read. It says it right there that the all land in the United States is owned by the United States, and any so-called ownership is only by mere usury at the behest of government. Okay, this was in their laws. We already did the video showing you guys this. Taking it to the actual congressional record and pulling that record up under archive.org. Pulling that record up and showing it to you. Let's go on. Like all other property in the state, is subject to state legislation so far. That means there's a limitation. As the legislation is consistent with the admission, that's a legal term. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a legal term, the admission. That the title passed and vested according to the laws of the United States. The admission. Why'd they say that? Well, we ain't gonna cover that right now. Y'all gonna have to do your research. In Michigan, the Michigan Supreme Court has taken the same position. Doesn't matter what position they take. And they're supposed to be taking the law. Now, let me show you. This is a direct quote. So how come federal and government is not capitalized if those are pronouns? How come public land is not capitalized? Interesting, ain't it? But United States is capitalized. No other word in this paragraph is capitalized with the exception of them highlighting the power. Pay attention. This is a legal term, the power. What power are you talking about? Well, they're talking about legislative power. Watch this. The power to sell and disposition of public land and of prescribing the rules, regulation, offices, agencies, and the whole course of proceedings for effecting such sales is vested exclusively in the federal government until the sale is consummated by the issuing of a patent to the purchaser, which alone, in ordinary cases like the present at least, divests the title of the United States and vested in the purchaser when, for the first time, it becomes, in all respects, subject to local laws of the state, like the great mass of other properties within its limit. Hold on. I want y'all to see how this idiot said something is a myth, and we're just finding out it's not. Let's not say this is coming from the Supreme Court. Let's say this is coming from the Supreme Court of every state, because this didn't change the laws in just Michigan. This doesn't just apply to Michigan. Notice what they're saying. The power of sale and disposition of public lands. The power and sale and disposition of public lands, the land sold by the government, the federal government, and land patents, and of prescribing the rules, regulation, officers, agencies, and the whole course of proceedings, administrative, for effecting such sales, is vested exclusively in the federal government, means it's federal jurisdiction. However, until the sale is commensurated by the issuing of a patent to the purchaser, that's why you can get a land patent, because this applied to every state. Whenever there was a sale of federal government lands to the purchaser, that constituted a patent, which alone divest the title of the United States. Now, hold on. I skipped that, didn't I? I did that on purpose. I want you to see the caveat, the exception to the rule in ordinary cases. Well, what if it's an exceptional case? What if it's not an ordinary case, but an extraordinary case? Which alone divests the title of the United States and vests it in the purchaser. When the United States issues a land patent, that land now becomes that of the purchaser of that land. It's alloidial. Pay attention. When, for the first time, it becomes in all respects, see, it becomes in all respects subject to the laws of the state, like the great mass of other properties within its limit. The state does not have jurisdiction over all property in the state. It has jurisdiction over all property for which the borrower or purchaser is an agent of the state, i.e. a taxpayer. But we learned yesterday that on your private property, your private residence, you don't have to pay any excise tax on your land. You just need to fill out the proper forms. Hold on now. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the rule. This is the rule. This is not just the same. You have the right to property, but you don't have the right to properties. You're allowed to have one personal property for yourself. It's called your primary residence. Secondary residences is not guaranteed by the Constitution. Constitution only guarantees the individual the right to property, singular, not plural. So don't go out there thinking you can get 15, 20,000 different properties. It don't work that way. So stop thinking. Stop being greedy. Yeah, you heard me. Ain't nobody else going to talk to you like this but me. Stop being greedy. Ladies and gentlemen, as we see here, for the first time, it becomes in all respects subject to local laws. Local laws, ladies and gentlemen, not statute. So the Constitution of every state says you have the right to property. The only time you don't have the right to property is when you relinquish that right to property. So let's see what this idiot has to say next. In Klaus versus Donowski, the property owner sued to establish the boundaries of his real property, which had been partially submerged by Lake St. Clair. The landowner objected to the state asserting rights over his submerged land claimed by the state under the Submerged Land Act. The Michigan Supreme Court agreed with the landowner that the court found that the property conveyed in the land patent, which had a clear legal description, was not lost to the landowner despite the fact that it was now at the bottom of the public body of water. The property owner's interest in this regard was superior to the state. The property owner's interest in this regard was superior to the state. The property owner's interest, who was a land patent owner, was superior to the state. But they just said it was subject to the state. No, in this case, they said it was superior to the state. Go back and look up that case. A land patent is a lordial title. But this idiot is trying to make it out that that's why I went here, because I wanted to see him tell us something wrong. And he's already done it. He's already disproved his own argument with his own words and court cases that he is bringing to our attention. Ladies and gentlemen, that's why they can't stand me when I walk in court, because I make them look stupid. I show how stupid attorneys are. Attorneys do not go to school to learn the law. The ones who actually learn the law are the ones who do the extra schooling, but the idiots go to school to learn all them stupid rules and policies and procedures and that stupid foreign language. That's what they go to school for. Hold on now. The relevance of most Michigan court cases interpreting land patents is largely been confined to that issue, i.e. land owned by individuals which becomes submerged by a water course that is then subject to public navigable use. The reference to land patents in such matters can be helpful in preserving property title rights to the submerged land. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not limited to submerged lands. This decision right here did not say it was limited to submerged land. What did it say? It said the property owner's interest in this regard was superior to that of the state. Why? Because it didn't matter that his land was submerged. Come on now. Y'all tell me I'm wrong. The Michigan Supreme Court agreed with the landowner, and the court found that the property conveyed in the land patent, which had a clear legal description, was not lost to the landowner. It didn't matter that it was submerged. So it has nothing to do with being submerged. It has everything to do with it's a land patent. Are you people following me? Go back and listen to the beginning of this up until this point and see if you get it. I'm not using my words. I'm using this idiot's words. I don't know who this fool is. I've never been to his site. But at least I don't remember being at this idiot's site. But I know when I do stuff like I'm doing now, trying to prove a point to you, I always use the enemy's junk because they do such a good job of making themselves look stupid. Look, the reference to the land patent in such matters can be helpful in preserving property title rights to submerged land, which incorporates a variety of related interests, including minerals, oil, gas rights. Hold on, ladies and gentlemen. I want y'all to pay attention. Want you all to pay attention. The land patent gives the individual the right to the minerals, oil, and gas rights. The right to construct piers, bridges, and other structures within the patented area. Now, hold on. Popular misconception. A land patent is useful to help define the extent of real property ownership. Unfortunately, a land patent will not anoint the property owner with the sovereignty of a king over the property it does, because every man is a king of his own castle. That's his land. He has the right to that. Nobody else has the right to your land. And your land cannot be taken away from you. Your right to be king over your land cannot be taken away from you without due process of law. Don't tell me that this is not the case, nor establish a patch of land for a private feudum or fiefdom. Doesn't matter. You cannot dodge taxes with a land patent. Ladies and gentlemen, no, you can't dodge taxes with a land patent. You have to get your land taken off the tax rolls. You do that by filling out the proper forms. We talked about that yesterday. Yesterday. Wait, hold on. I'm going to go ahead and open that up in the background. Now, it seems to be the goal of many proponents of land patent rights. Unfortunately, that is one of those urban myths, like sending a letter to the IRS renouncing all federal benefits in order to avoid paying income taxes. Nice try, but don't bet on that farm. Ladies and gentlemen, let me explain something to you. I don't have the video. I wish I did, but it's still up there on YouTube somewhere. Somebody has it, where I put my Social Security number up there. I call the IRS on the phone live, and I don't bleep nothing out. I don't pause nothing. I don't hide nothing. I play the entire conversation with me and the Ama Essa. And we say, hey, I just need to check to see if I owe any taxes. Okay, what's your Social Security number? And I give it to him. Okay, what's your mother's maiden name? And I give it to him. What's your date of birth? And I give it to him. And we go through that list. Not one time. Not two times. Not three times. Because after the fourth time, excuse me, let me go check another system. And then we go through it another three more times with me giving the person my information. And what do they say? Not that they think I'm lying to them. Sir, I can't find you in our system. Oh, thank you. That's all I wanted to know. Why? Because I just sent a letter to the IRS saying I'm a non-taxpayer. What? Wait. You cannot apply for tax credits if you're a non-taxpayer, people. You can't do both. So I'm no longer a non-taxpayer. I'm a taxpayer now. I pays my taxes when I owe them. But I write off everything. Just like that woman we were talking about yesterday. She told y'all, y'all need to be writing off everything. Okay? Everything. Y'all don't pay attention. I'm trying to get you guys to pay attention. These are the videos you need to be studying. Okay, so now that we, this idiot, that's all he had to say. Williams, Ratner, and Plunkett. Okay? Ladies and gentlemen, this is a bunch of junk. This was a bunch of junk. This was written by an attorney to dissuade people from doing land patents. Okay, so all I did was, what is a land patent? So we found out what a land patent is. It was a patent issued by the land office. Hold on. I'm sorry. Whew, I didn't finish it. I apologize. The Bureau of Land Management home. Now I typed in land office, the General Land Office. Welcome to the Bureau of Land Management, General Land Office. Welcome to the Bureau of Land Management, General Land Office. Welcome to the Bureau of Land Management, General Land Office. Okay, not currently contain every federal title record issued by the public land states. Ladies and gentlemen, I need you to pay attention to this. As I told you, the land office is still there. They still issue patents. So we're going to talk now. Are you ready? Let's find out where we at so you can tell your friends. If you don't want to listen to the whole video, you just need to go here. 42 minutes, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, this is how you do a land patent. You get the, hold on, I'm sorry, I clicked that and I shouldn't have. What you're looking for is the TOWNSHIP and range for your property. It's called the Township and Range System. You get, go down to your land office for your state and you want the Township and Range, okay? The land office is in your county. That's where your property is registered. Okay? Sometimes it's the assessor's office, sometimes it's not. But you want the township and range for your property. It's real simple to get, doesn't cost you any money. It's all you want, it's township and range. Write it down. Right? No, write it down because you ain't gonna do it. You're gonna look stupid. You want the township and range, ladies and gentlemen. Now, after you get the township and range for your property, you want to go down to, and I'm going to tell you to take that trip, BLM, and we're going to do BLM, let's do, because they didn't mention the state, so let's do Vegas, V-E-G-A-S, okay, watch this, Las Vegas, field office, Bureau of Land Management, look, got phone number, wait a minute, let's say I don't want to do Vegas, let's say I want to do New Mexico, N-E-W, because I know where they are. They Santa Fe. M-E-X-I-C-O. Because that's where I went and got my land patent. Lord have mercy. Bureau of Land Management. They got, I'm sorry, they do have several offices. But the main office is in Santa Fe, the state capital. Okay? I've been there. Okay? I've been there. It's way up past Albuquerque. Right up there is Santa Fe. Okay? I've been there because I live right up in here. Right up in there is where I live, okay? 2.2 million acres! All right, sorry, my bad. I wouldn't see, there it is right there, Santa Fe, New Mexico. That's the office I went to. Okay, you tell the gentleman, I need to get a copy of the map of the land for my property. They'll ask you for your property. And you give them all the description, give them the longitude and latitude if you have to. But they're going to need the township, and they're going to need the, dang it, I just lost it. Just see, I should have wrote it down, huh? Huh? So you're going to give them that information. They're going to say, okay, here it is. And they're going to present it to you. And they're going to tell you, did you like a certified copy? You're going to say, oh, most definitely, I want a certified copy. They're going to give you a copy with a ribbon. What a ribbon. It's got a ribbon on it. Oh, that's such a great ribbon. Ladies and gentlemen, what you're going to do with that land patent is you're going to take it back home. And you're going to create what's known as a, pay attention to this, G-R-A-N-T-D-E-E-D, a grant deed. Now watch this. We don't want a quick claim deed. We don't want definition. We know grant deeds came from Ulysses S. Grant, okay? We want a grant deed. T-E-M-P-L-A-T-E. See what I did? Okay, recorder use only. This is going to give us our grant deed templates. We don't want a warranty deed, y'all. This is saclaw.com. S-A-C as in Charlie, L-A-W, law.org. Okay, watch this. Hold on, I'm gonna download this because it's gonna go to my PDF escape, because that's where we were going a moment ago. So I want y'all to know. All right, form a grant deed. Okay, because I got to do this anyway. Now, you know, it has the assessors and parcel and all that stuff, and you see it says transfer tax if exempt. If exempt, if exempt, if exempt, did you see that? If exempt, want you to pay attention because we're going to go there. If exempt, enter the R and T code. Hold on. I don't know what R and T stand for. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. I don't know what R and T stand for. I told you we're going to get back to Cutie Pie in a second. Okay, where's my copy? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to get back to One Way and Cutie Pie. All right. Transfer is exempt from fees. Did you see that? This is the government code. This is California. I already know this is California because I see government code. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, transfer is exempt from fees. Do you understand? They already have a code for exemption of taxes. You just have to follow the procedures for your state. This is for California, County of California. What do you do? What do you do? Well, here's the thing. And this is the giraffe that you get signed before you put it on the record. This is the acknowledgement. So what you do with this thing right here, see that right there? Watch this. I do H-E-R-E-B-Y-A-C-C-E-P-T. This I'm sorry, and then you go on and on exactly what a land requires. But you have to do an acceptance. You see, ladies and gentlemen, you have an acknowledgement. Doesn't matter what the acknowledgement covers. But with all land as, see, there's your acknowledgement. Okay, you're accepting it, grantor, grantee. That's the whole thing, grantor, grantee. Okay, and the following, we don't want to do real property. Okay. Let's do... Oh, I gotta do edit. Sorry, y'all. Sorry. There's another word for it, but it's not real property. See, real property makes it statutory. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna suggest. Now, pay attention, ladies and gentlemen. This is California. If there is an exemption in California, okay, we did say RT code, so let's do the RNT code. If there's an exemption in California, there's an exemption in Michigan. There's an exemption. Let's do this. Hold on. You see where I put grantee template? So we're going to do this. LA. No, I don't want to do that LA. Let's do New Orleans. New Orleans. Okay. Orleans Parish grant deed form, Louisiana. Wait, hold on. We ain't going to stop there. What y'all doing? We're going to do F-L-O-R-I-D-A. Okay, watch this. Florida grant, blah, 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 grant deed forms. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Miss Lady Sunshine. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is all you have to do. Once you fill out your grant deed, once you take it to the county recorder's office, I want you to pay attention to me, because if you don't pay attention, hey, one way, hold on, I gotta talk to him again. I'm sorry, but this is very important. They need to hear this, because this is the number one mistake everybody makes, and some people have ended up in jail by not listening to this. So one way, y'all hold on a second. Ladies and gentlemen, I do hope you're paying attention, because everything I've said so far, if you're not paying attention to this, you can end up landing yourself in jail. You're going to finish the deed. Don't add a bunch of stupid language to it, people, please, because you will cancel out your deed. Just add that you're accepting, because there's an acknowledgement there, so you're accepting this land, along with its patent, along with its mineral rights, water rights, and usage rights, and all other rights associated thereto. And go ahead and do so in, which is being, oh, sorry, we got to do one more thing. Sorry, I gotta add one more thing, and you guys got to pay attention to what I'm about to add. Watch this. See what I just did? That's right. I did that. Uh-oh, I didn't mean to do that. Whew. Lord have mercy, I didn't mean to do that. Let's go here. And uh-oh, didn't want to do that either. I don't know what's going on. Uh-oh, didn't want to do that either. That's what I wanted to do. Hereby grants to the grantee in fee simple. And then new owner, including the current owner, is staying on title. So that's where you put the new owner information, but you want it to be in fee simple. Okay? Now, a grant deed is the land itself. It's not the topsoil. A warranty deed is the topsoil. A grant deed is everything all the way to the foundation of the earth. Okay? All the way to space. That's your grant deed. That's where you own. With a grant deed, with the patent. Now pay attention. You're going to take this once it's complete, and see, I got to go look up this code to see which exemption applies for my nonprofit organization. I'm doing nonprofit because we gave it to the nonprofit organization, so leave that alone. You don't need to do it that way. We particularly registered this in the organization's name because we have some work to do. If you're not paying attention, ladies and gentlemen, this is TTOPP.org, the Threat Outbreak Preparedness Program. We will talk about this later, but this was before COVID. This program was set up because of COVID. We knew it was coming, thus the threat outbreak preparedness program. So I want you all to pay attention. Look, this was 2018. Before all of this happened, we had this website put together before the end of 2018. Okay, notice this. In recent history, there has been one natural disaster after another. Why? Look at Indonesia. Three major earthquakes above 6.5 on the Richter scale in the past week, September 2018. Final week. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's what this was set up for. So our property is listed in the nonprofit organization intentionally. You are not going to do that. But you're going to look for the codes in your state because each state is going to have their own form and their own codes. That's how you're going to register your property. And you're going to finish this document. You're going to get it notarized. When you get it notarized, you're going to put the land patent. And by the way, that's the other thing right here. Uh-oh, I messed up. Let me do this right here. Hold on. Come on now. You're supposed to work with me. Oh, sorry. Can't do that. Let's see. Does it? Yeah, that's me right there. That's what I need to do. I need to do that right there. See how that was too bunched up? And then let's go back here. Yeah, I can't really do much about that. I can see, and I don't want to do that. That's too much. So I'll go there. I'll give it some more space. Okay, and then I'll come back here by doing this. And I just want to show you what I'm going to do because I got work to do. Waters. And let's do S. Well, uh-oh, I messed up. Wait, hold on. It's not letting me go any further. Oh, that's because it's its own set box. I'm going to put the age of the majority. Okay, but what I need to do is this box needs to be, let's see if it will let me move this box. I don't think it will let me move the box. Yeah, I don't think it will. Edit form. This should let me move the box. It ain't letting me move the box. Move the crowd. And the problem is right here when I lowered this, so I'm gonna have to bring this back up. You know what? I know exactly what to do. Dag Nabbit. I know exactly what to do. I'm glad y'all watching me do this so y'all can do the same. I hope y'all have a copy of this software at your houses. Okay, we're gonna go here or here. Nope, here. Let's do right there. That's what I want right there, but it ain't gonna let me edit. I wanna edit. So let's go back here. Nope, that ain't gonna let me edit. This is edit. So let's do, nope, that ain't gonna give me that either. There's got to be a way, because I want to see, it's got me locked out. So I don't know how to unlock that. So let's see if I can get to, yeah, I'm grayed out. So let's do bold and let's do true. But no, it says false because I'm locked out. That's the problem. Oh, well. Oh, I know what to do. Duh. Hold on, ladies and gentlemen. I apologize. Sometimes I amaze myself. Copy. Delete. Okay, get rid of that. Whew. I'm so glad we made it, y'all. Okay, and then we gonna paste that. ONERDIRTHCERTIFICATEACCOMPANING. I know. I thought I could get away without putting that. Uh-oh. Sorry. You're gonna keep it the way I had it. Accompanying this PRESENTMENT. Okay. Then your signature goes underneath. Now, I'm glad I did it the way I did it, because if I hadn't, this would have been locked in that other box. Take a look, and what I want to do is I don't want to bring no attention to this. I'm not going to bold it or anything. I'm going to leave it exactly the way it is. I do hereby accept this land and all associated encompasses, fixtures, minerals, waters, as well as the affixed, annexed, and attached federal land patent from the Federal Land Office in my attaining the age of the majority. Uh-oh, I forgot. I forgot. I apologize. CAPACITY. Okay? Because you want to be in your attaining the age of the majority capacity when you do this. Why? Because I'm going to tell you something that ain't nobody else going to tell you. The government does not have any jurisdiction over one who has attained the age of the majority. Yes, you will attach your birth certificate to this filing. You follow me, people? You're doing exactly what Minnesota Court Rule 220 says. You are filing your birth certificate on the record with a land patent. That is your right. It is your land. You have the right to record your land. Okay? This is the grant deed. And because of the ownership of the land, this is how we are doing it. You follow me? You got it? So, with that being the case, ladies and gentlemen, this is how, if I were you, I would record my land. Now, remember I told you about people going to jail? You want to attach. That's why I spoke of the land patent is affixed, annexed, and attached. You do not want to attach this to the land patent. You want the land patent attached to this. You don't have to do a UCC when you're filing this. File the UCC secondary. File your grant deed first. That's what you're filing on the record. Remember, this is their form. It's for this state. Okay? So they will file it, and the grant deed is a government form, but you cannot alter that government form because that's a violation of law. Cannot alter it. And this one you can sign under penalty of perjury because you know that you're doing that. Now it says in California, notary public or other officer completing this certificate verifies. Hold on. They don't like me, y'all. I don't know why they don't like me because I treat everybody with kindness and bubblegum shoes and house trees and everything. Everything! Hold on. Select text. It won't let me edit this, y'all. This all-purpose giraffe. It says you ain't touching nothing. Look at that. It won't let me edit this. Oh, they must know exactly who I am. Oh, doggy. They don't want to mess with me because I'll give them something. I'll edit some stuff. Look at that. Select. This won't even let me select like the other page because the other one is done. I know what the issue is. Just like I can't change California on here or nothing. This is what's known as the all-purpose Jurat. I can always add another all-purpose Jurat. I don't have a problem doing that, but I don't mind using the one that's here. I don't mind using this form. See, this is not a, okay, you see this one right here? This one is an image. I mean, a doc that I can edit because of the way it's designed. This is a picture. Look at this. You see this box, how it covers the whole page? Watch this. Okay, how everything moves? The other one doesn't do that. So this is a picture. It's not a document. They did that so I can't edit it. However, I can pull up the other. Watch this. I want you to see. Let's do this. I can affix the acknowledgement here all over again, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to use this one. Okay? Because this one, watch this. I can do my typewriter, and I can say County of, watch this, USC. That's my county. Okay, you follow me? So I can fill this in, even though it's a picture. I can still use PDF Exchange to do so. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is what I would be doing if I was doing a land patent. Okay, we're going to save this document. I'm going to save this document because I need to. But if I'm doing a land patent, this is how I'm doing my land patent. Okay? And I'm recording it on the record. I'm not arguing with anybody. I'm not saying, no, I got the right to do this. I'm not doing any of that. If they say, no, we can't file that document, I'm sorry. This is my land, isn't it? I am allowed to record my land, am I not? Well, we can't file that document. Sorry, what's wrong with this document? Well, it has that and that. Are you telling me that you don't file land patents? Are you telling me that land patents are illegal in this state? Can you please show me that law? Okay, well, I tell you what. I need an appeal form. Oh, you have to just write something and we'll respond to it. No, I'm sorry. You have a procedure and a process. Yeah, that's the procedures. You got to put it in writing. Well, I tell you what. I'll put it in writing after I speak to your supervisor because I need to file a complaint. I believe that you all are discriminating against me because of my race, because of my ethnicity, because of my religion, because of my political affiliation. And I don't think it's right. And so I need to file a complaint. And then, ladies and gentlemen, you put your issue in writing and you go through the administrative process. You follow their procedures. Okay, once you follow their procedures, pay attention, everybody. Once you follow their procedures, once you document everything in writing, once you give them 15 days to resolve the issue on the first level, then you appeal that. Give them 15 days to resolve that issue. Now you're giving them a total of 30 days. They haven't resolved it. Let them give them the notice of the fact that they have defaulted in their obligations to provide you a remedy. Okay, you heard what I said. They have defaulted in their obligation to provide you a remedy. The fact that they have not provided you a remedy allows you now to notify them of an opportunity to cure the default. You have now 7 days to cure your failure to provide the appropriate remedy for this situation. After 7 days, give them the notice of intent. I'm going to seek judicial review of your actions in denying me my right to access the government because you have a right to petition government for redress. And then you're going to go to the court and you get the fact that they denied you your right to petition by not giving you a remedy, by not responding to your request. And then you attach to that the rules that they have for filing a grant deed or any other type of deed being recorded at the recorder's office. Because the rules are going to say nothing about you can't file a grant deed. They're going to try to stop you. You know they're going to try, especially if you guys add a bunch of other junk and other language like some of you guys do because you're hard-headed and you don't listen when I tell you not to do it. So do not email me asking me what do I do now. after you didn't listen to me the first time? Ain't nobody else telling you how to do a land patent but me. Okay? I told you about township and range. Ain't nobody else told you about that stuff. Come on now, we have land patent information in our PDF files. But I'm giving you the simple way of doing it. The same as I gave everybody the simple way of doing adverse possession, and people didn't look, they didn't listen. Told them how to do it simple and how to follow the law. If you pay attention, I'm telling you to follow the law, follow procedure, follow policy. You've been hearing me sing this every single video, so nobody can say that this man is sitting up here trying to get people to break the law. No, this man is telling you, follow policy, follow procedure. It's there for that reason, to help you, not to harm you. Ladies and gentlemen, this right here is a simple video. And look, one song. This video took one song. That was one way, everybody. And you gotta love one way, because they were letting you know this whole time that there's only one way to do this. I didn't put that song up there purposely for that. Oh, I'm sorry, this is the second song. I apologize, because we had Whitney Houston. All right, but ladies and gentlemen, just so that you all know, this is how you do a land patent. This is the simple way. I couldn't show you what I did in New Mexico because I added a little bit more. I added a little twist to it. Ooh, doggy, y'all don't want to play that game. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is malware bites. I'm not even doing anything on the internet right now, but these are these idiots trying to access my computer. Why? What are they doing? Why are they trying to access my files? Well, it's a browser exe that's on my computer, and I'm gonna have to take care of that browser exe. Okay, it says it's I see what it is. I'll take care of that. What happens, ladies and gentlemen, when you're, and that's just one of them. That's the actual browser that's trying to access the internet. Now, it may be trying to do an update, but I don't care. Don't got my permission to be updating nothing. Okay, this is outstanding, y'all. Okay, y'all know about outstanding, but this is more than outstanding. See, this is a bunch of groups. Okay, so it's the Gap Band, the Commodores, the Temptations, it's everybody. See, I put an entire mix of songs. Okay, let me show y'all. Hold on. Come on now, what's the next song? You see what I mean? And so there's a bunch of mixes. This one, this is a slow jam. Watch this. Hold on. Okay, so I see what it did. It wants to play only one song at a time. I don't want that, but it is a mix. See? Slow jam. Body and soul. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the reason why we did that is because we want to give people more than just the normal, the simple music. Whitney Houston, take good care of my heart. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to bring this video to a close. Wanted to definitely thank all of you. Look, ladies and gentlemen, I'm at 93.5%, if you want to get technical. And I mean 83.5%. And I have to get to 93%. I'm not going higher than 93%. And then I'm taking down the donate button. If this information about land patents benefits you, your grandmama, if you can start a company helping people land patent their property and not charging them an arm and a leg to do so, it doesn't matter what value they're going to receive. You charge them a basic fee. If it's me, I'm charging somebody anywhere from $45 to $100 a land patent. Don't do $250, don't do $150, because you're not doing no work. You're going to make them go down to BLM. You don't have to drive down to BLM. You're going to make them go down to BLM. That's their responsibility. You're going to make them go down to the county recorder's office. The only thing you're going to be doing is providing them the paperwork. Here, take this down there. Okay? You're going to make them put forth the effort to help their own property. Now, if they want you to drive by on the BLM, then they're going to have to pay you for your time. Okay, that's, you work at, that out with them. But if I hear any of you, if it gets back to me that some of you guys are overcharging, like there's this guy named Dwayne Collins. We're going to talk about Dwayne Collins very soon, because Dwayne Collins sat up there and took our SatPac programs and was sub-selling it to other people. He was acting as if he was a seller of our products to other people, charging them $1,000 more than what we were charging them. And then using us to complete our own process for those individuals. I'll be putting his information up soon. I want to let you guys know about people like that. If I find out you're doing that, if it gets back to me, I will plaster your junk up here too. You don't get to sit up here and mess with my processes that I'm giving you and take advantage of other people. That ain't what this is for. I don't operate that way. This is not about taking advantage of your neighbor. This is about showing love for your neighbor. That's what it's been about from the beginning. Some of you people ain't got no sense. You didn't have no sense when you were born, and you ain't got no sense today. Don't get mad at me because I'm telling you the truth.
Well, ain't nobody ever talked to us like that. I don't give a who never talked to you like that. Maybe they should have, and you wouldn't be the way you are.
I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. That's how upset I am about the fact that people taking advantage and people doing stupid things and not listening. Okay? Go back over this video at least twice before you attempt this, because it isn't as simple. It's easy for me. I can spill this stuff out with no problem. Told you, I did this in 2012. Been doing this, not my first land pack. There is nothing illegal about it, as I just pointed out to you. Well, no, I'm sorry, the attorney pointed out to you. I showed you how the land management office is still in existence. It's now known as Bureau of Land Management. Okay, so the land patent office is still there, and they will give you a certified copy. They won't argue with you, they'll give it to you because that's their job. The government cannot not give that to you upon request. You have to pay a fee. The fee is nominal. It's not that much. Okay? And if you want to get two certified copies of the land patent, hey, by all means, but you cannot put any markings. You cannot label one, land patent two. You can label a cover letter. And yes, you can do a cover letter. But you cannot attach anything underneath the land patent, so you can't put something under the land patent. The land patent always has to be under your paperwork. It cannot be above your paperwork. Pay attention. The land patent has to be under your paperwork. It can never be on top of your paperwork. Why is that? Because if you put the land patent on top of your paperwork, whatever's underneath is considered an addition to the land patent. That means you've added to the land patent, which is a violation of federal law. You cannot alter a federal document that has the federal seal. You can't alter a state document that has a state seal. People, y'all need to pay attention, because some of y'all can get in a lot of trouble because y'all don't know how to listen. Ignorant and stupid is what ignorant and stupid does, so stop being ignorant and stupid. Y'all heard me. I told you I ain't got time for mixing and twisting and ripping my words apart for you guys. So y'all better be like, thank God, like this guy singing in this song. Oh! Sorry about that, y'all. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you all for your help. I want to thank you all for your assistance. And I'm hoping that some of you are going to appreciate this, because I know many of you have been wanting this information for years. And just nobody would tell it to you. People would always charge you to do it for you. Well, now you can do it for yourself, because somebody's giving you the information and he ain't asking you for a dime. Go back and pay attention to the video. I haven't asked y'all for a dime. Oh, yeah, you asked it to contribute. No, I asked you to contribute to the project because of TTLPP, what we're getting ready to start. And if you want to take a look, it's TTOPP.org. That's all, TTOPP.org. This is what we'll be doing. Okay? Already, look, all you got to do is understand, TTOPP, all this stuff is already here. Okay? What I have to do is I now have to find an architect to design the dome homes. I won't have one initially because I don't have enough time. but I will have a structure placed on the property. Okay? So I just want all of you to know this is where I'm headed. If you're ready to head there with me, then we can talk. All right. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be bringing about 7 people on at SACOM. If that is something you think you might be interested in, what do you mean? I was about to say, it said it can't be reached. That's why I was pausing. I know. What do you mean it can't be reached? I know all of these pages should be working. This site has been in the waitings since 2018. They haven't even touched it because we're not doing anything with it. But ladies and gentlemen, they're messing with our emails. They're messing with our mail. We've been sending out emails to people and people are telling us that they're not getting it. We're getting a bunch of bounce back emails, which makes no sense. And the company who we get our system through can't explain it. Now, people say, well, why don't you go to another company? Because it ain't the company, people. It ain't the company. It's the government and those wonderful people who they use to assist them to interfere with our junk. All right, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen, ladies and gents, this is how to do a land patent in the United States in 2021. All right? Gotta go. Y'all take care of yourselves. I hope everything continues to go well for all of you guys. And again, the donation button is underneath this video. Thank you once again, everybody. Thank you for allowing me to bring a different mix to y'all today. 1 hour and 21 minutes. I'm sorry about that. Goodbye.